Hi my lovelies, welcome back to a new video. It's Gina here and welcome to my art corner. If you subscribed while I was doing Inktober, then you probably don't know, but I actually try to balance traditional art and digital art. I will be honest, mostly I don't get the right balance and mostly I draw traditionally, but I try my best to draw digital in between so I learn that medium too again. At the beginning, when I was starting to color and use colors, I actually really learned a lot with digital art. It may sound funny, but it really helps to sometimes use a different medium that you can pretty much just erase and learn a lot from it, learn colors and everything to get confidence with colors before you go into traditional. Because let's be honest, you don't have a lot of traditional art that or like traditional mediums that you can work on forever and erase and work again on it and so on. And with this drawing I was like, okay, I want to try this to make this digital painting. It's not even just a drawing, it's kind of almost painterly like, and try my best to see if I can make it a little bit more my style. And man, did I struggle, like with the background. I hate myself that I actually really considered doing this background. It took me way too long till I discovered how to actually make more like the selective outtakes, I don't know how they're called. And then after I had it, till I colored in or like painted in this whole thing, it took me way too long, like I have to sped up super fast so you can't like see all of it, how long it took me, and even now it took me around 1.5 minutes because it was so long. And then after that I decided to make this kind of sketch, and on the sketch I worked also quite a bit because I was just like, my problem with digital art is just this. You can make it so many times, you can flip the canvas, which is amazing. You can erase and like undo it and everything, but at the same time I think it's bad because I tend to try to make it perfect. So while I was sketching, while I was drawing and painting and such, I had like always this flip the canvas, now erase it, no it's not good. And after a while I was like, this is terrible, like I didn't like it, and I was like, okay, take a break. And I think I was 2 or 3 days on this drawing, at least 2, I think it was 2, I don't remember correctly, I think, but around 2 days. So as you can see now, I have the line art, I slowly putting down the base colors. And actually it's not that bad, but at the time I was just like, this is really hard, like I don't know what to do. Then I decided to put in the original drawing, not just as a reference, but as a reference for the colors. And after a while I was like, okay, this doesn't work out that great, like I put down the base colors, and after a while I was just like picking and pushing and smudging and trying my best that I could to make it kind of resemble but still being a kind of my style. I don't know if it really shows, and I was like, okay, now I have the line art, now if I take out the line art, should I make it pretty much this kind of realistic thing without line art, like my other ones that I tried in digital, or should I leave the line art? And I was trying and trying and trying without the line art, and I was just like, you know what, I will leave a sketchy line art. Who the actual, I don't want to swear in videos, but I just didn't give a F anymore because I was like, okay girl, you actually want to practice with this? Sure, you want to upload it and show it to others, but let's be honest, like a practice doesn't have to be perfect. And it's not perfect and it's alright. So if you're practicing something, you don't have to have this mindset, it should be so amazing. Of course, try your best, but don't go crazy with it, like me. And it's just really like, as you can see here, I'm really struggling to give it the shapes. And now, looking at it and watching back, it's not that bad as I felt at the moment when I was drawing it. I still had fun, but at the same time, I just, like, I'm searching for a style, because this painterly style is really great and amazing, but I sit a lot on it and I don't quite know if a style shows through when I paint like this. And actually I'm pretty happy that I found kind of a style, like almost a style in traditional art, and now I really want to try to incorporate that into digital, but of course I'm still learning again with digital art. It's not that easy because I use a different program than before, because I used GIMP before and I pretty much forgot everything with GIMP. So I decided to use Krita, and Krita is a really good program. It's also for free, and guys, if you have a tablet or anything different, like really fancy things, try Krita. It's really amazing. If you have a fancy tablet, you don't need a fancy program too. And I just like really, as you can see, I'm smudging, I'm putting color here, I'm putting color there, then I'm trying to like blend it and smudge it, and I'm still figuring out how to make everything. And after a while you can see that I'm slowly getting into it, like really slowly, because pretty much I was like 3 hours into this drawing or painting already, I believe. And at the end I can say that it's not perfect. It has a little bit sketchy line art, but at the same time I like it. It has a something different of a style and has different, like, it's not something that I normally would draw like this, and I kind of like this painterly style in digital because I don't have it in traditional that much, not that often at least. And I think it's interesting to see how different someone's style can be when they use different mediums. So let me know in the comments, are you more a traditional artist or a digital artist? Are you trying like me and put both together as much as you can? Or yeah, what do you like more from me actually? Do you like my traditional or my digital art? I will do both, because I think for an artist it's always good to know both, because you never know if any client comes and wants something different from you that you're normally not used to. Like, sure, don't have too much, like, it's good to have a variety, but not tackle everything at the same time, if this even makes sense. But yeah, this is pretty much what I wanted to talk about, or more like brabble about. What I think that I really love about this drawing are the eyes, like the makeup on the eyes. I love how this orangey turned out, it's so pretty. And, well, yeah, now really, let me know in the comments, what do you think about this drawing? What do you think, or more like, what do you like better? Let me know, and also subscribe if you haven't already, and hopefully you will stay if you subscribed in Inktober. I will have some black and white drawings too, and maybe I will try some more like darkish drawings in color, who knows. I will try my best to differ as many as I can, and thank you so much for watching, and hopefully I will see you then in the next video. Bye bye.